There's still so many people who don't know what does a data engineer do. Don't worry, you're watching the right video. Have you ever wondered who manages the massive amount of data that drive your favorite applications and website? You use applications like Instagram that gets you right content that you want to watch. You go on Amazon and you find the right product that you want to buy. You are watching this video on YouTube, but you are still getting recommendations for the next videos that you might like. Do you think all of this is magic? No.
It's not magic, it's talent and sweat.
Imagine a gigantic library, but instead of books, it is filled with the digital data. Text, images, audios, video. Data engineers are the librarian who manages all of these digital data. Data engineering is one of the most promising career paths. It is going to cross 100 billion market cap by 2028. Their job is to organize, manage, and maintain all of this data so that data scientists or business analysts can take the right decisions. But what is the need for all of this? Think about this, right? If you go on Instagram and if you don't find the content that you like, if you go on Amazon, but if you don't find the right product that you want, will you still use all of these applications? No, right? This is the need for this. Companies want to understand their users' behavior so that they can improve their overall product and services and also increase their profit. So they use all of this data to understand what their users are doing, what their users want, and based on that, they take the data-driven decisions. This is the need. Companies want to understand their users' behavior, improve their product and services so that they can grow and make profits. Here's what the typical day of a data engineer might look like. As a data engineer, I will have multiple things to do. I will go on a call with the business stakeholders or data scientists to understand what kind of data that they need, and based on that, I will process the data. I might have the existing pipeline running in the company. My job will be to monitor all of these pipelines and check if they are running properly or not. Let's say it is a Monday morning and I sat for my work. I'm checking the health of my existing data pipeline and are this pipeline running properly or not. Think of this pipeline as a water pipe. Instead of water, they carry the actual data. All of these data are coming from the multiple sources. So what I need to do, I need to combine all of this data, make it into the structure format so that business analysts or the data scientists can take the right decisions at the end. My job will be to make sure there are no leaks and everything flows smoothly so that data gets where it needs to go without any issues. This will be my job. I'm the owner of this data pipeline and I need to make sure everything runs as expected. After this, I might have a call with the business stakeholders and they told me that they are adding the new segment in the business and there will be a new data source. While I need to manage the existing pipeline, I might have to add the new sources of data. So I will have to think about this also, like how do I add this new data source into my existing pipeline? How does this new data source get connected with my existing data source? It is not just about making sure the existing pipeline, I also need to think about how do I build a new pipeline. Now I will have to sit and understand what is the new data source, how they are connected with the existing business data, and create a plan to ingest this new data source into my existing system. Build a data model for this and document the entire process. Like this, there might be multiple things I might have to do as a data engineer. And you are not doing all of these things alone. You will do all of these things with the team. Imagine a retail company that wants to recommend product to the customer based on their browsing history. Data engineers will set up the pipeline that collect and process customer data, ensuring the recommendation system gets the latest information. Let's try to understand the basic architecture behind the system.
So as you can see in this architecture diagram, we have data coming from multiple sources, Google Analytics, Google Ads, SQL databases, and website shop data. Now, all of these data are coming from the different sources, and these data might be in a different format. What we need to do first, we need to ingest this data into our system so that we can build a pipeline. So there might be multiple services or technologies that you can use. In this case, this is hosted on Microsoft Azure. So we'll be using related services such as Azure Functions, Azure Data Hub, and Azure Data Factory. Now, these are the different services based on your data frequency and the volume you can use to ingest your data into your system. All of these technology decisions are taken by the data architect, like what kind of technologies that we need to use in order to ingest the data. Once we have our data ingested, we need to store this data. Now, in the case of Microsoft Azure, we have something called as Azure Data Lake Gen 2. This is the service that we can use to build a data lake. We also have the data catalog available, that means the metadata about our data. So anyone wants to understand what kind of data, the columns and the data types we have, we can use this data catalog. Once we have our data available, then we will use this data and write the transformation function using Azure Databricks. So Azure Databricks is the Apache Spark hosted environment. So if you want to extract the data and write your transformation job using Apache Spark framework, you can easily do it over here. Then once you transform your data, then you can load your data and do the analysis using Azure Synapse. Now here you can use any service that you want, such as Snowflake, You can use BigQuery. Again, this is hosted on the Azure platform, so you will go with the Azure related services for the better integration. Now, this architecture you can easily transform into the open source architecture. So instead of using Databricks, you can use the normal Apache Spark. Instead of using this, you can use any other service. Instead of using Synapse Analytics, you can use something called Snowflake Database, BigQuery, as per your requirement. Once you have this, then we have the data science, machine learning engineers, or the business stakeholders who can check the dashboard and take the decisions based on that. So this is the basic architecture, just to help you understand what kind of data architecture you will be facing in the real world. So all of these things are not straightforward. You write some code and magic happens. Data engineers face challenges like data inconsistency, scale, and ensuring privacy. For instance, when you deal with the multiple sources of data, inconsistency of data are quite common. Some of the data type format might be different in one source, and some of the data type format might be different in another source. So as a data engineer, you might have to make sure all of these data type format and all of the data types of the system come into the same format at the end. Data engineers also write the algorithms to clean and standardize the data, ensuring it is usable. They also have to think about the scalability, like if the data grows at the huge volume, how do I scale this entire system? They also have to think about that. So data engineering is not just about using a bunch of tools, connecting them together, and you are done. It is more than that. But while we are talking about different tools, what are the different tools data engineers use to build this data pipeline? Well, it depends on the company to company, but I will give you some of the high demand tools available in the market that data engineers use in their day-to-day lives. For example, if you want to create a basic data pipeline, there is a tool called as Apache Airflow. In data engineering, we have something called as ETL, Extract Transform Load. In this case, you extract data from the multiple sources. The sources can be RDBMS, third-party APIs, or sensor. Then you transform this data based on the business logic, and then you load this data to some target location. It can be a data warehouse or some storage system. This entire process, you can easily do that using the tool called as Apache Airflow. In Airflow, either you can write Python or SQL script, integrate it with the multiple system like the cloud providers. So for this, you will have to learn the basics of Python and SQL, because you will be writing a lot of Python code and you will be dealing with multiple database system. So you need to know SQL, structured query language, and how to communicate with the databases. So you can learn the basics of SQL, how to write the basic SQL queries, how to get the data, how to insert data, delete some of the records. All of these things are the basics for data engineers. So these are the foundation skill set that you can learn Python and SQL. So you can write the transformation logic using Python and SQL script. For the loading part, you can learn about the data warehouse tools. These are the tools that are designed for analytical workload. So when you want to find the answers to the questions such as, what was the last 5 years of revenue? How did we do this month compared to the last 5 years? You can easily get the answers to all of these questions using data warehouse technologies. These data warehouse technologies are built for this kind of workload only. So these are some of the tools that you can use, such as Google BigQuery, Snowflake Database, AWS Redshift. If you want my recommendation, then you can learn about the Snowflake Data Warehouse. For transformation, you can use different frameworks. So one of the most powerful framework available for transformation is called as Apache Spark. Using Apache Spark, you can process billions of data in just within few seconds. If the data science teams need the data in the real-time format, then you can use tools or the framework such as Apache Kafka that is capable of processing all of these data in the real-time manner. Most of these data are in the huge volumes, so you can never process them in your local PC, and that is the reason you need the huge computing power and the storage system. So you usually use the cloud computing platform. These are the three cloud providers available: Amazon Web Services, Google Cloud Platform, and Microsoft Azure. You can pick any one cloud and get started. If you want my recommendation, you can start with the AWS. This is the cloud computing platform that I started my career with. Another good option is learning about Microsoft Azure. Again, you can just pick one cloud provider, stick to it, learn it for the 3 months, and you'll be good to go. Again, what is the need for learning only all of these things on the first place? Think about when you shop online or get the recommendation that you want, or when you use the application that works seamlessly. This is all thanks to data engineers who sit behind all of this processing system and make sure you get the right recommendation, you get the right data and right experience on the application side. So next time when you stream your favorite show or go shopping online, remember, there is a data engineer who is working behind the scene, making your digital life smoother and smarter. Pretty cool, right? Again, there are so many different things data engineers do. If you are worried about artificial intelligence taking your job, remember, AI completely depends on the right data that it needs to be trained on. And data engineers are the people who make sure the right data gets processed. AI models are totally dependent on the data engineers. If you don't have the right data, AI models will not be able to generate the right outcome at the end. So data engineers are the backbone for the AI models.
Data engineers is one of the most promising career, as I said at the start of the video. So if you want to get started in the data engineering, so if you're interested in starting your career in data engineering, then you can quickly start your career using my 4-course combo package, Python SQL Data Warehouse with a Snowflake and Apache Spark with the Databricks. These 4 courses comes with the 5 different projects, and you will learn everything from the in-depth theory to the hands-on experience and build the different projects to build your portfolio. You will find the information about my courses in the description, so if you're interested, you can check it out. Are you a data engineer? Let me know in the comments what is your day-to-day task so that other people can learn from you. This was all from this video. If you learned something new from this video, then let me know in the comment section. Like this video, subscribe to the channel if you are new here. Thank you for watching. I'll see you in the next video.